So when we are sad or we are feeling low, when we are happy or feel energetic, we hear to your music. What do you listen to? What are the artists you listen to?
I listen to you.
Oh. Sir, good morning. It has been my lifelong dream to be here in front of you, and I can't express what I'm feeling right now. But thank you for giving your time.
Hey, my pleasure, man.
Thank you so much.
You're making a lot of people happy, and they're all smiling. I think it's a very good thing to do.
Thank you so much, sir. Thank you. We have seen your journey from music to filmmaking. It's very fascinating, and I would like to know what inspired you to turn into a actual story writer, because you have been telling stories through your music for like decades now. And what made you turn into an actual story writer?
I think combination of many things. You know, in 2001 when I went to London, I met Andrew Lloyd Webber, thanks to Shekhar Kapoor introduced me. Then he said, AR, do you have any story? I said, why is he asking? He's a composer, I'm a composer, why should I write stories? And then I realized that he's also part of storytelling, theater and all that stuff. And I said that, and I was, we shared a, you know, apartment with Shekhar Kapoor. And he used to come up with stories sitting on a chair, and he'll tell stories like, when did you think about this? Just now, he says. I said, wow. So, you know, when you mix with great people, you also tend to start. Then, and Dave Stewart is another example, which he comes with ideas. And so this happened, and then I kept traveling. When you travel, you see, meet people. You see different cultures, different lives, and then you realize stories are very important and perspectives are very important, and stories through your eyes, through your perceptions is also very important, because if we don't have different narratives, there'll be only one singular narrative will be there. Because you know, if you take a cameraman, a normal person can shoot something, but a cameraman's perspective is different.
Right.
Same storyteller's perspective is different. And so that led me to, I was going the flight. 2010 was a very heavy year. My daughter's surgery happened, open heart surgery. Grammys happened, Commonwealth Games happened. And then this tour accident happened. You know, it was a pretty devastating year, good and bad.
All right.
So I think it was a relief. I finished the tour as promised, went back to the US, performed. So I was coming in the flight and felt a kind of lightness, and I was thinking, now I should write a story. And the story is about how does one guy has to write 100 songs to win a girl.
Yeah.
It's like a fairy tale.
Right.
I had to learn so many things, because if, you know, it's never advisable to go into something which you don't know.
Yeah.
And if something wrong happens, then you're left in the road. So I wanted to learn everything. If something goes wrong, how do you fix it?
Right.
And storytelling, and you know, in color correction, camera and lenses. I bought lenses, I bought cameras. I built a big studio, and so this is just probably the foundation for filmmaking, not just for 99. So
then you didn't think of directing it yourself?
That is where the catch is. Yeah. If I have to direct, I need to give 2 years of my lifetime.
Right.
That means I have to leave all the music.
Mm.
If I leave music, then I think first of all I will be devastated.
Yeah.
Not leave music, like, you know, because you're. I felt like, get a director, dump all the stuff on his head and be light.
Yeah.
So, boss over him, bully him. He's a very sweet guy, Vishwesh, and we have a nice rapport.
So, the story revolves around, the film story revolves around, there's one song and then music can change everything. And last year during the lockdown, the exactly same thing happened with me. One of my videos got viral, and
the one song changed your life.
Yeah, absolutely. Hey. That is actually the reason why I am sitting in front of you today. That one video has changed everything for me.
Yeah.
What is that one music piece or video or film or anything that has changed everything for you?
Roja.
Yeah.
Roja. And then it gets better and better and better. And I think for you, it's not just that one song. It's your whole being, your whole intention, your emotion, soul. Everything comes out at a particular time, you know, because you're destined. Nobody can take it away from you. If this had not come, something else would have come.
Yeah.
I feel like, so we should never feel like, oh, it's gone. What's meant for you will come. I've seen that happen, because inherently that whole, is like oil under the ground.
Right, right. All this while, because filmmaking is a very long process and there are multiple people involved. Mm. It is not just you. How do you maintain that objectivity till it gets to its final product?
Yeah, I think ultimately, you know, in my life, I always look at the end result. Where is it going to be shown? Who's going to hear it? Who's going to watch it? And I will try to become that person. So I'll do a song, I'll listen to the car. I'm not the composer, will I like it? I'm not the producer, I'm not the writer, will I like it? So what does it take? Because people have these choices, and why should they choose my film to watch?
Right.
Why should they? Then I go, like, we don't have this kind of a scene, we don't have this, but also not spoil the integrity of the purity of the movie or the song. So it's a very simple, you know, check I have. I tell my engineers also.
Yeah.
Like, you do all the stuff, play some of the song, play the song. Where is this?
Compare.
And so it's very, very easy. You don't have to, you know, put this thousand, you know, odd plugins and do all the stuff. Finally, is it yes or no?
Okay.
And this is the check we always have.
That is why all your songs also sound different from what is going on in the market.
That, I don't know, that's because of my, I don't know, my tastes and the things which I want to give.
All that's right. Why. So there's one part is conveying emotion, that is the art part of it. The art, other part is craft of writing. So writing a story requires, you should have knowledge about the characters, their sub-characters, this climax, this everything. How did you come up with that?
So in my, you know, when I look at the song, always have, like once Maniratnam ji told me, like, you know, AR, story writing is nothing but like how you create a song.
Yeah.
You have a melody, you have a surprise, and you have a BGM, then you have antra. Then you have an end. So, but wholesome, there's an experience, an emotional experience, and it leaves you an impact. So, in my opinion of songwriting, I mean, story writing is, have these pillars. If something also sags here, this other pillar will come and save it.
Okay.
So, these points are there. And then through that, go deep and have something which is bigger than the movie, you know, which has to say, not preachy, not moralistic, but also at the same time, we all have this sense of humanity. We react to human things, acts of kindness, acts of love, then, you know, awe, you know, when something happens, when disaster happens, and also surprises, and also the karmic things which happen, like you do this, this happens. Not in a formulaic way, but that's the truth. We all see that. If somebody does a lot of bad, you see that, oh, you are doing this stuff and this happened to you. And so, the combination of many layers, it's not just, can't say it's a love story, it's not just a musical story. It's philosophical in a way, but it's also edgy, it's young, and I'm very proud of the cast. Yeah.
Talking about the cast, we got to know that Ihan had to learn the piano from KM Conservatory. And was it a prerequisite for this role?
Yes, because you've seen great actors in the past in Hindi films where they do guitar like this.
Yeah.
But they're charming. People have accepted that.
Yeah.
But you know, younger people now will learn guitars, they'll learn pianos. You can't just again do that stuff. Because being a musician, if I you know, cast somebody and they just mime, it's not a good idea. You know, even though it's some of the stuff is miming, but he knows all the keys. He's learned for 1 year. We sent him to Hollywood for 4 weeks for a workshop.
Okay.
All that happened.
So we saw the trailer. It looks amazing. And right from the first logo, Wire Movies logo came in, we see that you have this fascination for technology, right from your first album also. Whenever a new sound comes in, you try to integrate in your music. And we see the most newest instruments in your live shows also, which we haven't seen or anywhere else. So have you always been fascinated by technology?
No, I just... It's not about technology, it's about doing things which emulates more organic things.
Okay.
Like if you take a keyboard, it can play, you know, definite pitches. But when I looked at Madeline Srinivas and man, this, he's doing so much of gamakas and, you know, harkats, I'm not able to do that on the keyboard, I was very frustrated.
Yeah.
And then the continuum came. I said, yes, Srinivas, I got the continuum. So even I told him, like, when he's alive, you know, that time it was very, the basic versions. Now it's got a much better version. So the continuum came. Again, it's an instrument where you can't suddenly play the violin. The violin takes like 15 years to get in tune. So continuum is probably like 3-4 violins together.
Yeah.
Because you can play with two hands.
Two hands.
And the pitch is completely fluid.
Yeah.
So your mind has to be if I practice for 1 hour, I can play something decent on the country
yeah.
before any concert or before. Mm. So.
So when we are sad or we are feeling low, when we are happy or feel energetic, we hear to your music and we feel this spiritual connect with you and your music. I have heard people saying that when they hear Kun Fa Hai Kun, they know that there is help around. They can oh. they, that gives them hope. And that has happened with me also. I have like a very spiritual connect with your music.
Thank you.
What do you listen to? What are the artists you listen to?
I listen to you.
Oh. I'm going to frame this forever, this little clip, I'm going to put it everywhere.
Because I think sometimes you need fun and you're giving that fun. And of course, I have this, sometimes I go back to, I have this app where I get classic FM, mm-hmm. which I listen to symphonies. And when I'm down, I listen to Nusrat Saab. Then I listen to Kumar Gandharva. Uh-huh. And so it depends on, sometimes I don't listen to anything.
Mm-hmm.
I just, I'm like, yeah, sometimes silence is better. Take just off. Meditate yeah. and just get everything out of your head.
Right.
Feel peaceful. Because there's so much of noise. Yeah. Noise in the sense, not little noise. Noise of information, noise of in, you know, so many different things. So sometimes being silent gives you peace.
So what we know from your other interviews also, you're a very private person. And now you're promoting a film and all that requires is going out and telling people, you know, being in the limelight.
Yes.
How is the experience? How are you handling it? And what is the favorite experience of the filmmaking process? And what is that part that you
filmmaking
do?
Filmmaking is very cathartic, you know, because you write something and it becomes true and it becomes like larger than life with
yeah.
music and visuals and action and you feel like, and you literally get tears.
Yeah.
Like it's manifesting into reality. And there's also a scare. If you mess it up, you lose everything.
Mm.
You can get humiliated by millions of people.
Yeah.
So I've been playing the movie, tweaking it and just really getting the cut which we need. And I think we're all proud of the product because it's not just me.
Mm.
It's so many people, the cast, you know, there's Vishwesh and there's the producers and all of them believing in it. And also people who are waiting to see what's happening. So this movie is an experience, you know, we just from just storytelling to an experience, like it goes back and forth. And that's when music can shine.
Yeah.
Because music is becoming a wallpaper now. Like even in Hollywood, when you look at it, the stuff playing, you feel like there's music, but that you don't remember anything. It's just a textual thing. Not in every movie.
Yeah.
So we felt like unless you write things on the script, like this is how this piece is going to be shot. This is how it's going to be executed. There can't be any musical, you know, moments in the movies.
What do you think about the future in the music industry? Because of the internet penetration, everything is accessible to everyone.
Mm-hmm.
There are independent artists coming up. There are established artists who are coming up with their own label companies. What do you think, in which direction this is going? Is this going to be good for the music industry?
I think there's a burst of amazing things happening. And it'll all settle down. It's like survival of the fittest. You know, everybody comes up with great ideas. How much can somebody fuel it again and again and again to survive it? How to reinvent yourself and make yourself more appealing for the next generation? And the needs are also there. Sometimes you give what they want, sometimes you give what they need. And that is, the people with power should do that. Wait, what you're listening to is nice, but you know, listen to this one.
Yeah.
But if you listen to this stuff, you'll get more soul satisfaction.
Mm.
Till Kun Fa Hai Kun, it just existed. After that is when you get all this reaction. Before
yeah.
that, nobody knew that a song
right.
like that can exist.
Right.
It is a combination of Imtiaz Ali, Irshad Kamil, and Mohit Mi, and all of us trying to do something which is right for the movie, at the same time giving something which should last long. It's not just a movie material, but we wanted to make. Like every song, we all try to make it timeless, but
yeah.
it has its own.
So experimenting is the only thing you can do.
Yeah, just give your fullest to it. And even now in this,
yes.
the Hindi version released a year back,
yeah.
99 songs.
Yes.
And I saw the movie and I felt like Hum Nawa needed a beat.
Oh.
So we saw the screening and then I put the beat after.
Oh.
Just a week back, we added a beat and a string arrangement so that it has that interest you know, in the second.
So after the song is done, you go back to it?
Yeah, we go back. Oh, you don't care.
Very interesting.
I mean, if the movie releases tomorrow, if I have an option, I'll do something.
So on that note, sir, thank you so much for giving your time, and this, I hope this becomes a big success, and this is my lifetime dream to meet you, and it has come true today. So thank you so much.
I'm wishing you the very best, and make people happy. Yes. And yeah, great. God bless.
Thank you so much.